I'm doing this because I am in love with the ocean. I am in love with the ocean at large, but I am particularly infatuated with the Balearics. I grew up here.
They're really proud of what they have here, and this is an opportunity and time for us to celebrate that, but also to push forward to get more protection here in the Balearic Islands and to show that we've only started this process, there's a lot more to be done.
We had the special privilege of being Stefan Hirst's guest underwater. And the people who do dive here have kept this as kind of a secret. And now we want to share the view.
I grew up here, I skinned my knees here, I stepped on urchins, I got a really neat start here.
It's easy to see why people come here, just on the land. It's just stunningly beautiful, the geology, the natural beauty of this place.
It's very important that we bring oceanographic luminaries and pioneers such as Dr. Sylvia Earle and her team here so that they can better understand the island. We're going to take a look at one of Mallorca's, one of seven Mallorca's MPAs, and we're going to immerse ourselves literally in the beauty of what Mallorca has to offer us. It's just a true honor. It's kind of living a dream.
Are you ready?
You look ready. I'm always ready. It's so beautiful on the surface. I know it's going to be at least as magnificent underwater. And to meet the fish, let's go.
Yes, let's do it.
We're heading out to El Toro Marine Reserve, which is one of the seven MPAs that we have here in the Balearic Islands. It's one of my favourite dives in Mallorca, and we're going to go and take the Mission Blue team for a special underwater adventure in the Med.
I wish everyone could share the view I had when I rolled off the back of that boat today and plunged into clear water. Great school of the barracuda, these silvery fish with big toothy grins and an attitude. They look at you, and I was looking at them. It was this contact. And the same is true with this beautiful big scorpion fish, rosy red, big eyes. The time I shared with the seagrass meadow, with the nooks and crannies, the caves that were filled with beautiful curtains of red algae, and it's just exhilarating. When people care and take action, it does pay off, and we're witnesses to that today. I've been diving in the Mediterranean before in many places, and nothing I have seen before compares with what I saw today. It was the diversity of life, the quality of the systems, the big fish, and there were a lot of fish, especially things that I don't see elsewhere, like big grouper. And the grouper we witnessed today were probably 20, 25 years old.
So what'd you think?
I think it was magnificent.
Was it all that you expected it to be and more?
I wasn't sure what to expect, except that I knew it was going to be good. And we even saw grouper and little barracuda and moray eels and just a wonderful array of things.
The hard work that we've all put into this, I don't think it's actually measurable to have quite a lot of attention coming in from Sylvia Earle, Mission Blue and the Sylvia Earle Foundation is a huge result for what we're doing. And really the sort of the solidifying factor for the foundations that we've been building over the last few years.
This is the first part of the Mediterranean that has been designated as a hope spot. I want to congratulate you and celebrate what you're already doing right here to protect the assets, to protect your life by protecting the ocean. Dividends come when you protect the assets, and already what's happening here is paying off. There's a reason for hope
for the Mediterranean Sea generally, for the ocean generally, but very specifically, the opportunity you have right here to be a beacon of hope for the world.
Stefan Hirst has grown up here. He really loves the place. I think he's shown an extraordinary commitment. We need people like Stefan Hirst to really do this type of work so that the rest of us can also share in it and help support local efforts.
We have learned more. We understand why the ocean matters. We understand why it isn't just for the benefit of the fish. It isn't just for the benefit of the tourism industry. It isn't just because these places are aesthetically pleasing. It's because our lives really depend on securing protection for the ocean, from which we have taken so much for so long. It's time for us to give back.